guys, this is Catherine here, how are you? And welcome to a game called Room Number 2. This is actually a sequel to a game I played a fair while back called, funnily enough, The Room. I don't know anything about this, it's probably going to be more or less the same, and I really enjoyed the first one, so hoping that this will be pretty good as well. Realised a couple of things right off from the start. The music extremely familiar, though I cannot for the life of me work out where it's from. And the time on that clock there is actually the time. It is actually 10:37 p.m. So that's actually a pretty cool little mechanic there. So let's get to it. Let's start the game. Hope the music's not too loud. And yes, there would be a loading screen. But I've got my timer set for 15 minutes, so see how we go. Click to begin. Good old tutorial. Okay. Click and drag the mouse to look around. Yep. Typical game mechanics. So this is a puzzle game. Double click on the note. So I'm guessing this is a note. Click and drag. Okay. What's this say? If my calculations are correct, then this is where you will emerge. Welcome, friend. We have much to share. Now, you are blind. I'm not blind, I can see. But I've left you provision to see that your passage might be shorter than mine. Mm-hmm. I am forced to conceal it somewhere within this room, and I trust your wits to uncover it. I am not the only ghost in this place. A.S. Now, I wonder if that's the same A.S. that was in the first one. Probably. All right. Click the eyepiece in the inventory. Familiar from the first game. Of course the lens is broken. I'm guessing that's the lens there. So, I'll just do a click somewhere. Click that. Okay, cool. Right click. Cool. Zoom out further. So I'm guessing you just right click. Awesome. Double click on the other table. So this is the other table. This must be the puzzle. Double click on the round box, which is this. Rotate the whole keyhole cover. So I'm guessing this is the keyhole cover. Awesome. Button. Click and drag. You know what? I can probably turn the volume off a bit. Puzzle. It looks like some of the objects can be moved. Okay, so. Right, so here we go. Okay, so can we move them? Okay. I think I see what we need to do. So that. Alright, so this first puzzle. Okay, so we need that. There we go. Then, two. Yeah, that took longer than it should have. Slide open the door. Get the lens out to that. Should go there. Cool, alright. Lens look like it'll fit into the eyeglass. Now, let me see if I can work this out too. Click on the eyepiece. Oh, there you go. Okay, so it did itself. Fine. Click to where the eyepiece. Ah. Sometimes the eyepiece can be used to see things that are otherwise hidden. Now, that's the same mechanic as what was in the first one, too. Now, I'm guessing you remove this. No, okay. Ah. Rub. Pick up the piece. That's a rub. Small piece of shaped metal. Nice, okay. I should try to find where the piece can be used. Yes, that might be a good idea. Click to remove. I don't know. Fine. Okay, fine. Explore the room. I'm guessing the next one will be this. Maybe? Would that fit in here? No? Okay. Alright, so let's zoom. Yep, okay. Let's zoom out. Can we zoom out? Yep, okay. So, let's go exploring. What about here? That looks like it will fit in there. Small piece of metal. Yep, okay. Now. There we go. There we go. So that should fit in. No. Okay, fair enough. Okay. So, does that fit? No. The question mark button. No, we don't want to use hints yet. Yeah, I know there's a piece missing. I don't want to use hints yet. Okay, so. What if that goes on the side? Okay, So, are there any only two places that are available at the moment? Let's go back over here. Where is that it? No. Okay, something's something's moving there. We don't want to use a hint. Not this early. We don't want to use a hint on the first puzzle. These look like runes. Those are envelope. Can we look at that? Lens. We look at the envelope. Ah, there we go. Alright. Ah, there it is! Oh. Okay. Ah, here we go. Mr. Rigby, suffice it to say that I do not share my colleague's faith in your character. Were it up to me, I should not engage a man of such low breeding and even lower station as yourself. The very thought of taking the grave robber into our service chills my stomach. But as Mr. De Montef, something or other, is fond of saying, needs must as the devil drives. Okay, fair enough. It falls to me, then, to brief you in the ungodly task, as it should be well aware you should only be paid upon successful return with the artifact. Should you find yourself having any ideas otherwise, I must stress to you that while this artifact is of enormous value, it is only of value within a certain small community of researchers. It is not for the eyes of or hands of an uneducated man such as yourself. I unconditionally demand that you do not interact with the object in any way. It might prove incredibly dangerous for you to do so. It is an instrument of great power and should not be interfered by any inferior mind. So, enormous value and great power. So, that's 1883. Bloody hell. Okay. Alright. So, can we do anything with that red thing? No, we cannot. Okay. So, we'll zoom out. And we'll see what else we have. Can we combine these two? We cannot. Okay. Right. So, can we put them in here? I think I know where they go. Yes, alright. We'll go over here. And echo. Go in here. And we put one here. East, south, west, north, because they're cardinal points. Okay, south, east, south, west, north. Right, so zoom in. So go south. So we've got something in there. Okay. Alright, so we put in that. No. And can we put that? Okay, so we can't move that. Footprint, unless put these here. There we go. Awesome. Right. What's this? Alright, so we're zooming here. Southeast, south, west, north, I think. South. No, still missing something. Alright, what's this? Can we move? Can we do anything? Okay. Look. Nothing. Bigger wheel, right there. And there. Hooray! Right. What the hell does that do? Strange, but so that. Yeah, I know. I know where it goes. It goes in here. Right. Sphere. Yes. That's freaky. Okay, south. I know what the code is. South. I know what the code is. South. Okay, south. East. South. Okay. Right, so I've got to figure this out. Okay, I can't get stuck on the first one. South. Right. East. Ah, shit. Okay, alright. So, south. Right. East. No. Ah, okay. South. East. South. West. North. Medallion. Medallion. Okay. The history is not taken close off. Alright. Move those out. Oh, that's pretty. I wonder if anything matches his shape. Have I seen that before? Okay, let's go back. Let's go over here. Yes. There we go. And that seems to be the first puzzle done, I think. Yep. Alrighty. Well, that, ladies and gentlemen, is the introduction to the room 2. Now, if you played the room 1 before, you might be familiar with. With the puzzle mechanics and the running around and doing stuff that may seem very, very duplicated, you know, stuff that you may look back and forth all the time. So this looks to be like the second puzzle. I'm not sure, because it keeps on going behind it. Why does it go behind it? The lens. If in doubt, use the lens. Ah! There's that. Okay, so we're looking for those symbols, are we? Ah, there's that one. See the hourglass. That, whatever that is. Oh, that is awesome. Oh, okay. To actually make the symbol that appears all the time, that's a symbol. Okay, so what we need to do is move the lens to make that. Oh, okay, wasn't expecting that, but okay, move the lens so it makes that so it makes that symbol, and there we go. So you got to finish that symbol. And there we go. Now that is awesome. I hope the sound isn't too loud. I have turned. What? Oh, chapter. You've done well to emerge from the crypt, sound of both mind and spirit, though I fear this is only the beginning of your trials. Well, that was cool. That's the first chapter. Alright, so, alright, well, that was good. That was a good start. So we'll continue, and then we'll exit back out again, and we'll revisit this in another video. So, I'm liking this game already. It's got very similar and very, like, the same mechanics as the first one. The sound is pretty cool. The graphics is awesome. And it looks like we're on a boat. So I'm going to leave it there. So I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. Bye.